today's lesson is to show a demonstration of the dissection of the pig's head, and to demonstrate the dissection of an eye, an activity which you're going to be carrying out later. Where this fits in with the curriculum is in the fact we're understanding the way in which sense organs are connected to the brain. We'll be examining the brain, and we'll also be thinking about the structure of the brain, how it relates to the sense organs. In B7, which you'll be coming on to next, as part of your GCSE biology course, you'll have to understand the structure of the eye in detail, and so we'll be looking at that in detail. So, this is the pig's head. We're going to start with an examination from the outside of the pig's head. This pig's head only costs about £2 because it's considered a waste product from the production of your bacon, your pork chops. It's actually a very good source of meat. Some people take these and boil them and take the meat off. Or pig's ears. My dog loves pig's ears. They are really pig's ears. They're cut off and dried. Okay, so these we cut off and dried. And
what would they do with the head normally?
Normally, it could go to variety sources. It's very hard to get the meat off, so usually it's just bin.
There's loads of meat.
Okay, but it's hard to actually, in a factory intensive process, it's hard to get it off. That's why usually if you cook them, you just boil the whole head and then you can strip the meat off. Examining the, just turn it around so you can see the front. Okay. I'm going to wear gloves just because I don't, not because it's not fresh, because it is fresh. If this wasn't fresh, I wouldn't need to wear gloves, but the gloves basically is just because of the smell. When you're doing the eye dissection, you really don't need to wear the gloves. Although you can do if you want.
What are the eyes from?
Now, the eyes are actually bull's eyes, and I'll show you why, because the eyes on a pig are incredibly hard to actually get out. You three might want to find yourself another place, and if that's okay for you then. Now, it's been basically in the abattoir process, it's been killed. Also, depending on its farming technique, you often can notice damage around here as it's been chewing on the bars. I'm not exactly sure of the source of whether this is intensively bred, probably is, in which case you get teeth marks here where basically they constantly chew on the bars. It's a practice that they're thinking of outlawing, but that's you tend to get. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to use a scalpel blade to remove the epidermal tissue, that's the skin tissue. The skin, of course, is an organ in itself and a sense organ, so of course it has sense of touch. And we're going to remove the skin and we're going to basically fold down the ears and move off the scalp. But before we do that, is just to show you the spinal cord. Now, this is basically the top of the spinal column here. The top of the spinal column is here, and if I pull that back, that is actually the spinal cord coming out there. And if I put my finger through there, that will actually go straight through. Continue cutting the scalp off.
If this was a lot, you're cutting it.
Yes, from the capillaries, although not major blood vessels here, but the capillaries, of course, go through the skin. When you cook this, it actually breaks down this connective tissue, so it becomes very easy. No, but it's very common amongst people from less kind of intensely farming nations, or even actually people in this country would used to do it, but people have just basically got out of the habit of these sort of things. Basically because of the ease of supermarket meat. Now this is bone, there's a bit of tissue here, it's going to cut that off. Now, this is very hard. This is basically what pigs do. They've got a much thicker skull, and you're along here, they've got a cranial ridge. Two reasons why you've got a cranial ridge. One is to butt things. Two, because the muscular tissue here is connected through the jaw. Now this is the fun bit. What we're going to do is we're going to chisel away the cap, and we're going to hopefully expose the brain in one piece. This is the fun bit. Depending on how rotten it is, depends on whether it will be in one piece. So the brain actually is essentially a lot of water.
Aren't you going to mash the brain up?
Leave your stuff in his head. Give it a twirl.
This isn't the worst bit. The worst bit is yet to come. I have put in a bit for a circular saw. But it raised some eyebrows amongst the management when I asked for that.
I wonder why that is.
A couple more, and then we get to the fun bit.
Almost there.
Right. Hopefully, if anyone's too close to this, it won't matter too much.
This is the brain.
The brain is not very big. It's about 1/5 the size. So the previous question, what happens if you touch the brain? Well, nothing. And there have been experiments where they have actually...
There's no nerve cells here.
No, there's actually no feeling in the brain itself. And there have been experiments where basically you remove someone's skull cap very carefully, unlike this, with a circular saw, and you actually electrocute parts of people's brain to actually see what happens. And the people are looking at the most access as I can so I can actually get the brain out. And
could you go further down the nose?
Yeah, probably could. So it's sort of the V here. Now we need to listen. Okay. Now we get to the fine difficult part. The brain is essentially very watery. It has a higher content of water because it's a higher solute, because it basically is to do with electrical conduction. And when you think about boxing and damage, the way the brain is in the brain cavity, it moves around, it can get damaged, and this is what happens in boxing. If you get punched, your brain will collide with the side of your skull, causing it to damage. And what surrounds it is something called the meninges membrane. The meninges membrane goes all the way down. It's basically what happens in meningitis. It goes all the way down through the spinal column, and it's basically what holds this material together. Now, this is the bit I'm not sure I'm going to be able to do, and that is...
Shaped.
Oh, let's see if I get it out first. And that's to see if I can actually prise the brain out without breaking the membrane. Because if the membrane does get broken, it will just be sludge. Now, this isn't going to come out in one go.
Anyone got a corn sandwich?
That's actually good. It's what I've done is actually removed it from the membrane. The membrane's there. And what's good about this is you can see That's tiny. All of the right? You can see the folded nature. You can see the two clear sides of the brain. Okay. And you can see
with the hammer. That's what the sword's for.
And you can see at the back the connection to the spinal cord, which is here. Now, anybody is feeling sick, this is the bit where you will feel sick. To prove a point, I'm going to prove that the spinal cord is connected to the brain. There's my finger. And then I'll do the eye. The nose is really impressive, simply because of the fact of the amount of nerve cells on it. And we're going to basically take the nose off here and show you the nasal.
He's got that many nerve cells.
The AMI biology.
Instead of a scalp.
Welcome to the show. Coming up.
Tommy Walsh.
Andy Henry.
Now, the teeth on a pig like this are often ground down because it can bite on the bars, and you can see there, going through here, are the nasal passages filled, and it's folded around, and it's filled with loads and loads of sense receptors. It's got a better sense of smell than the dog, okay? It can smell things very, very well, and they go all the way, and these nerves then, so you can't really find the nerves, they're very hard to find, but the nerves would run straight to the brain. Pig's eyes are housed very deep. Why?
So they don't fall out.
Because they don't fall out when they do what?
When they're headbutting
things. And whereas the bull's eyes and your eyes are actually very easy to remove, in actual fact, you may remember the stories of Pig's got an ocular dislocation. In other words, you sneeze too hard and your eye pops out. It has happened.
Sir, Pig sneezes.
Its eye is very deeply embedded, and this is where I'm going to take the eye out, and it's going to be quite deep. I'm going to cut the eyelid back.
So, if you cut yourself, would you catch anything?
Whoa.
Now the hard bit is basically removing the eye.
Now it looks angry.
Shh. It's removing your eye by cutting the ocular muscles, which allow the eye to move. No, there isn't a direct access from behind, it's a cavity.
George's got a guy with a cry.
He looks like
George, open your mouth, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
It's very tough.
Oh, it's actually probably like gripping.
Yeah, the body's holding on.
Where's his eye gone?
Come on, sir, I want to see his eye.
Just cut it off. Jamie,
Jamie, if you can look at your own eye, I'm going to tell you.
First of all, this is much tougher to get out than any other thing because it's so held in there by tissue. In a human eye, if you want to do an operation in a human eye, the way they do it is they give you an anesthetic which weakens the muscles, and they can actually just remove the eye and rest it on the cheek while they're doing an operation. But this is a whole different kettle of fish because it's not supposed to be removed. And if it's human eye, in effect, and it's very tough. It is really, really tough. And the white tissue. It's a bit sticky to be honest. You're just going to splat. The white tissue.
A little bit against
the wall. There's something in my eye.
So if you run underwater.
Right. Shh. Stop talking. Stop talking.
He's got his eye on.
The white tissue is known as the sclera, the white of the eye, and that is really, really tough.
If you run it underwater.
Now, can everyone just listen? I'll just explain this first so we got before we cut it, and I'll take any questions. The front of the eye, of course, you can see, is covered by a transparent section called the cornea, a thin layer which has come off called the conjunctiva, which contains the cells that help support the eye. That's where you get burst blood vessels and blood vessels in your eye, and that's where you have to be careful where contact lens is. And then here, although it's difficult to see on the pig, is you can actually, it's got the iris, which is a ring of muscle for controlling the aperture, the amount of light into the eye, and the pupil, which is nothing but the hole, which leads to the back of the eye. The whole eye is inflated with a liquid known as the vitreous, and the vitreous basically transparent liquid. It won't look transparent when you get in here because it's probably been in dead for a while, it's a bit murky. It's transparent, it allows the light to go through, so it's not empty, and it's that actual vitreous you have to be careful of because if the pressure in that's too high, you can get something known as glaucoma. Now, this is a bit where you get it. So you're going to get an eye like this, it's going to be bigger because it's going to be a bullseye, but essentially what you're going to do is the same. Take a pair of scissors.
Are you going to stab it? That's disgusting.
Now,
what did you see? One eye was
hanging
out.
Well, you see the other eye. Place. Talking. Place it on its side. It's got to be on its side, and with the point of your scissors, do you only have scissors for this and the point of the scissors, you're going to punch it into the side of it, and this can be quite, the liquid can come out, but you need to punch it, and then once you've punched it, you're going to cut around it like cutting around a football. So hold it on its side like this, like that.
Lovely.
Oh, that's pretty
good. Oh, nice. Oh,
you need to
scalpel.
Yeah, it's
good. That is the windows of the soul.
Now, if I squeeze up, I'm going to pop out the lens, because the lens will just pop out.
It's like a beast.
A little bowl. The
miracle of
and there it is.
Oh, that's horrible.
That is a lens.
Oh, that is so cool.
Hard, jelly-like thing.
Can you set it on the lens? That's like the lenses we're using.
I'm
going to
use
those.
Well,
wow, surprisingly.
On the other side, you can see the black. And the black is the black layer of the retina. And the retina is black so that it doesn't reflect light around the inside of the eye. Now that would be really bad, because if light bounced around in the inside of your eye, you'd get multiple images. And of course you don't want that to happen. But there's one part of the eye that doesn't see. And if you look here, that's the optic nerve there. That little white bit's the optic nerve where it attaches. If you turn it around, you get this thing called a blind spot. And there's a spot on the other side, there is a spot, and that spot,
I see.
That spot there, white spot there, is where the optic nerve connects. And you've got no photoreceptors there at all. No photoreceptors at all. And you actually are blind in that spot, and your brain makes up what it sees in that spot. And we'll be showing you that when we do the practical to look at the eye structure.